Amen.
Amen.
In Him we live and we move and we have our being.
Amen.
Our God is not a little puny God. He's not a dead God. He's a mighty God.
Amen.
There is nobody bigger than Him. Can you imagine the wilderness journey in the book of Exodus? That is what Exodus means. Exodus, the way out. Every single day. They saw the pillar of fire by night. They saw the pillar of cloud by day to keep them from the hot desert sun. And you know the story. On the preparation day, there was twice as much manna. Sabbath miracle.
Amen.
And what they had to preserve for the Sabbath. It did not rot or stank or bread worms. Can you imagine the pillar of fire by night for 40 years? And the pillar of cloud by day. And the rock that followed them stood right next to the sanctuary. When they wanted water, they had a flow of fresh and living water. The rock represented Christ. He is the rock of ages, amen?
Amen.
The immovable rock, like the rock of Gibraltar. That rock followed them throughout the wilderness and stood next to the sanctuary. The rock represented Christ. The rock was supposed to be smitten only once. And had a flow of fresh and living water, like an artesian well in the desert. Amen. Their clothes did not wear out. Their shoes did not wear out. Can you imagine? You wish you had shoes like that even today. I wear so many shoes, you won't believe. Amen. For 40 years, their clothes and their shoes didn't wear out. Amen. And God protected them in the wilderness. They were fiery serpents in the wilderness. When God allowed them to be bitten by serpents, it's because God just simply withdrew His protection. But the serpents were always there. Amen? But they were shielded, they were protected by the God of heaven. His dream was, is this the day to enter the promised land? His one dream. Every day he got up from the bed with tent made out of skin. Is this the morning?
No.
To cross over the Jordan. Is this the morning? To march into the promised land. But they began to complain and murmur. And the Bible tells us that God loves every one of us. Amen. He loves us with an everlasting love. And with loving kindness, He has drawn us to Himself. Amen. I want us to turn to our scripture reading. It's in Deuteronomy chapter 3. And I saw the Lord at that time say, O Lord God, thou hast begun to show thy servant thy greatness and thy mighty hand. For what God is there in heaven or in earth that can do according to thy works and according to thy might? I pray thee, let me go over and see the good land that is beyond Jordan, that goodly mountain and Lebanon. But the Lord was wroth with me for your sakes, and would not hear me. And the Lord said unto me, let it suffice thee. Speak no more of me of this matter. Get thee up on top of Pisgah, lift up thine eyes eastward and westward and northward and southward, and behold it with thine eyes, but thou shalt not go over this Jordan. Can you imagine? You're living. And your number one goal The dream of your life is denied. His dream was to enter the promised land, the land flowing with milk and honey. And he was right. He called them rebels. Amen. They were a bunch of rebels, stiff-necked, hard-hardened. Can you imagine standing next to the Red Sea? And Moses stepped in and touched the water with his rod. And the water just parted. Can you imagine witnessing the miracle? And the next day when they had crossed over, they looked and they saw Pharaoh's army, the mightiest army, the horse and his chariot. Had he drawn dead bodies? Can you imagine? Coming through the wilderness, they had conquered every nation that came up against them. Every nation that opposed them, they had conquered. And yet they complained and murmured, just like us. Amen. They were looking forward, but we look back. Amen. To what had already happened, and we still complain. Because we want to have it our way. It was Johnny Carson, I believe, who said, my way. And this is what sin is. When we want to do our own thing instead of God's thing. Amen.
Yes.
Sin is having our own way instead of having God's way. His one dream was denied. You shall not enter. I turn your attention to the book of Numbers, chapter 20. Reading from verse 7. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, take the rod, and gather thou the assembly together, thou and Aaron thy brother, and speak unto the rock. Now the first time the rock was supposed to be smitten, amen? But this time God told them to speak to the rock before their eyes, and it shall give forth his water. And thou shalt bring forth to them water out of the rock. So thou shalt give the congregation and the beasts drink. And Moses took the rod from before the Lord as he commanded him. And Moses and Aaron gathered the congregation together before the rock. And he said unto them, hear now, ye rebels, must we fetch for you water out of this rock? Must we, me and Aaron? You see, Moses taught that the miracles that was being performed was because of him. Must we, Moses and Aaron, must we fetch water for you? We are just the instruments.
Amen.
Every kind of word, of thought, or action, or deed comes from God. It's a power outside of ourselves. There is nothing good in us.
Amen.
And Moses lifted up his hand, verse 11, and with his rod he smote the rock twice. Even when we are disobedient, the Bible says, and the water came out abundantly. The water still came from the rock. And the congregation drank, and the beasts also. There is an old Jewish legend that says that when Moses struck the rock, the first few drops that came out was red like blood. Sometimes the heart of God bleeds when we are disobedient. Because of the results of our life of sin, amen?
Amen.
But he loves us. The Bible says that the water still came from the rock. They had a flow of fresh and living water. And because of this incident, God said to him, you shall not go over the Jordan. The one thing that he hoped for, the one thing that he lived for, his dream, was to go over into the promised land. The land flowing with milk and honey. The one thing that we are living for, our dream, is to make it into the New Jerusalem, amen?
Amen.
That's our hope, that's our goal. Life is not worth living without hope. Nobody lives without hope. A person who is hopeless is suicidal. But we have this hope.
Yes.
That trouble doesn't last always. Joy comes in the morning. What do you say? Amen.
Amen.
Jesus is coming again.
Amen.
So lift up the trumpet and loud and ring.
Yes.
Jesus is coming again.
Amen.
The water still came from the rock. What a picture. All our good deeds will not make up, will not overlook the sins that we commit. Amen? I have a Muslim brother, and he's like an imam, what you would consider a pastor in the Seventh-day Adventist Church. He teaches the Quran, and I have good conversation with him, and one of the beliefs is that if you do enough good deeds, then the good eventually will outweigh the bad, as every other pagan religion teaches. Your good deeds must outweigh your bad, so you can make it to God as though you're trying to appease God by your performance. God knows us, we cannot fool him, amen? But Moses was in a high position. He was supposed to represent God to the people. Amen. He took credit to himself that should have gone to God. He took it upon himself. We are not all that important. Author reminds us that someone said that we are nothing, we have nothing, and we give nothing. On the other hand, God is everything. He has everything, and he gives everything.
Amen.
So you and I, what we say is not etched out in concrete. 99% of all that we know comes from somewhere else.
Yeah.
Very little or nothing that we possess or that we claim to know is original. We are not all that. So let us not think of ourselves more highly than we ought to. And what we say is not edge out in concrete. Amen?
Amen.
God loves us anyhow.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
We serve a loving God, what do you say?
Amen.
He loves us anyhow. Moses, God loves him so much. Spurgeon said, if your faith does not change your behavior, it will not change your destiny. If our faith does not change our behavior, it will not change our destiny. If we are good at our jobs, if we are all there sometimes and we are doing things that we are not supposed to, we'll have to give an account for it, amen? His dream was to enter the promised land. But God called him up on one of the mountains. God said to him, I will cause you to see it with your eyes, but you shall not go over this Jordan. He saw Lebanon. He saw the greenery. He saw Jericho, he saw the downfall, he had a panoramic view. He saw down through the corridors of time. He saw the babe being born in Bethlehem of Judea. He saw the ministry of John the Baptist. He saw the Sea of Galilee and Jesus preaching repentance. The kingdom of God is at hand. Moses saw the second coming and the clouds of glory. And he repented with bitter tears. He repented. And there in the book of Jude, when Jesus came down to claim his servant, the devil rebuked him. Jesus did not even have a discussion with the devil. He didn't argue with the devil. All he said is that the Lord rebuke you. Amen.
Amen.
The devil brings up all sins, Revelation 21, he is the accuser of the brethren, amen? God does not look at our faults and our flaws. He looks at what we can become by his grace.
Amen.
Grace is power to live above sin, amen?
Yes.
Grace is power to live above sin. The man who could not but did, he could not enter the promised land, the literal Canaan, but he did.
Amen.
Because there in the Mount of Transfiguration, Peter, James, and John saw Moses and Elijah. So that tells me that he did enter the heavenly Canaan, what do you say?
Amen.
The man who could not but did.
Here you go.
Amen.
Amen.
He did make it. You and I can make it. So when the devil comes to us and tells us that we cannot, we can by his grace and his mercy. Amen. We can make it by his grace and mercy. Dr. A.J. Gordon, great preacher of yesteryear, saw a little boy coming out of the outskirts of New York. And in his hand, he was carrying a cage. And in that cage, he had some birds. And he was curious, and he asked the little boy, what are you going to do with the birds in the cage? He said, I'm just going to have some fun with them. I'm going to play with them for a little bit. And when I get tired of them, I'm just going to feed them to my cat. Now, that did not sit well with the preacher, and he said, would you sell me those birds? And the other boy said, they don't worth anything. They're not useful. You wouldn't have any use for these birds. And Dr. Gordon said, will you sell me those birds? Can you name your price? And they gave him a price, probably $5. Dr. Gordon took the cage with the birds and he went out in a little clearing and he opened the door of the cage and he said to those birds, you are free, you are free. But they just huddled together in the cage. They would not fly out of the cage because they were accustomed to being in the cage. So he went to the back of the cage and he tapped the back of the cage and one of the birds flew out, and then another, and another. And they were chirping and singing. And he said, it is as though they were saying, redeem. Redeem, how I love to proclaim it, redeem. Through his infinite mercy, redeem. By the blood of the Lamb, his child, and forever. I am redeemed. I am free. Some years ago, Jesus saw the devil with a cage in his hands, and in that cage he had a bunch of humans. And Jesus said, what are you going to do with them? He said, I'm going to have fun with them and I'm going to enjoy them for a little while. And when I get tired of them, I'm just going to slaughter all of them. Well, you know that did not sit well with Jesus, amen? And Jesus said to him, will you sell me the... By the way, they did not belong to the devil. Amen? Greed does not belong to him. When Adam sinned, the earth did not belong to Adam. It belonged to a higher power. Adam was simply a servant. He was in charge of another person's goods. For example, if the governor of this state, Florida, decides to sell the state to a foreign government, and it is documented that he has sold Florida, will that document be binding?
No.
It will not be binding because he's serving a higher power. Amen? He's simply a governor of this state, not the United States. He's not the president. Amen? So you cannot sell that which does not belong to you. You are in charge of another person's good. You are not the owner. Amen? But because Adam sold out, we inherited from Adam a bent, a leaning towards sin. We could not in our own make it right. So our minds were warped, were dwarfed. So we enjoyed the presence of demons. And when God came down, they ran away from him. But God did not change. His law did not change. Mankind changed. So that's what Jesus came to buy back our minds. The battle is in the mind. If the mind is free, the mind is clear, then we are free indeed.
Amen.
It's freed only with the truth of God. Amen?
Amen.
And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
Amen.
Christ came to set us free from the lies that the devil has told. I really need to wrap this up now. But God loves us for this. Amen.
Amen.
I'm here to remind us, praise God, the time is coming when sickness will be terminated, sorrow will be obliterated, sin will be eradicated, disease will be annihilated, death will be exterminated, injustice will be prostrated, the wicked will be consummated, earth will be fumigated, Satan will be subjugated, evildoers will be humiliated, God's law will be vindicated, the saints will be translated, the church will be elevated, angels will be jubilated, peace will be perpetuated, the holy city will be populated, and praise God, Jesus will be coronated. Amen?
Amen.
So we can make it by God's grace.
Amen.
When the devil comes to us and tells us we cannot, yes, we can. The man who could not, but did. And all of us, by his grace and mercy, one of these days, we'll swing back those pearly gates on us. And by the way, the gates are always open. The only time it's shut when the wicked are resurrected and surround the city and march against the city, that's the only time the gate was shut. But the gates open, amen?
Amen.
That we may enter in. May God bless us and may this be our commitment. May this be our decision. If God be for us, who can be against us? Amen?
Amen.
If this is your decision, friend of mine, I invite you to stand as we turn to our closing hymn.
442. Hymn number 442. How sweet are the tidings.
Father in heaven, we thank you for your grace and your mercies. We thank you for the assurance that you have given us in your words. Thank you, Lord, for the hope of eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. We ask your continued blessing upon us and give us the power to live above sin. And help us to give you, O Lord, all the praise, the honor, and the glory. This we ask in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.